So season 16 gave us some changes to the Legends, where they basically calling it a remaster of the Legends. And with that, you guys are going to see that we now have a different looking type of Recon class and others as well. But we'll talk about those later on, you know, in future videos. If you guys want to see that, be sure to subscribe, like the video, all that good jazz. So I think the first thing that we need to address is that in the Recon section, you guys can see we no longer have Valkyrie over there. And I guess she just didn't fit the whole aesthetic of a Recon Legend. Now, that doesn't mean that Valkyrie herself still can't do the things that she was doing before, which is scanning people while she's in the air. That's still something she can do. She's just no longer a Recon Legend and doesn't get the benefit of actually scanning the beacon anymore. That's done for her. But going through the Recon Legends, we now have Bloodhound, Crypto, Seer, and Vantage. And with that, they gave them the ability to continue to scan beacons, but now it's different. Whereas before, the Recon Legends would see where the next circle was. That's now something that only a controller can do. And with the Recon Legends, it's almost like a UAV, like in Warzone or something like that, if you guys are familiar with Call of Duty, which I feel like most people should be. So you get a little recon. The one thing I will say about it, though, is it'll show where the enemies were last spotted, not if they're moving around and everything like that. So it's not crazy overpowered, but it does give you a general idea of where all the action is. So, you know, play around with that as you see fit. I don't think it's a bad thing. You guys can definitely be aggressive off of it, or you can kind of just play a little bit more smart and kind of avoid some action if you guys don't have enough loot or whatever the case may be. Take that and run with that knowledge that you guys see fit. I don't really have a wrong or right way to use it. So going through them, man, you guys know that those are the little changes. So let's go ahead and start with Bloodhound. Bloodhound got, I would say, a quality of life change. I wouldn't say they really nerfed them, because in my honest opinion, nigga, if you run around with Bloodhound, you're gonna be pretty solid. So some of the changes that they made to Bloodhound were, first off, they still get to go ahead and see the tracks on the floor and everything like that. That hasn't changed. The scans, that did change. Now, when you scan people, originally you guys are used to Bloodhound being able to scan and then you would see the body for however long that scan would stay up. Now you see the body for maybe 3 to 4 seconds, and then the remainder of the scan, you just see them as a diamond, like how you could with Seer. The ultimate was slightly changed as well, to the point where now whenever you use your the Beast of the Hunt, now you're still in that like sped up motion and everything. It's all the same for the most part, until you see the White Raven. I call the Raven a lot of different things. Ravenclaw, White Claw, I call him Enrique. I don't know, the bird's name is different every time, but the bird will lead you to wherever the last seen enemy was. And that's also a part of Bloodhound's passive. Now, it doesn't always happen as a passive, but every now and then you might see it and it'll pop up on the screen or on your map, and you'll see like this little sonar beacon kind of going off, letting you know that's exactly where the Raven is. It'll show for your teammates too, and they'll be able to see exactly which way the Raven is pointing, which I honestly think is a good thing. And I don't feel like it was a nerf to Bloodhound. If anything, it was kind of like a buff, because it'll go out, it'll find where an enemy is in that general direction, right? So now you know, okay, they're over there to the left or whatever the case may be. Then once it's done doing that, it'll pop back up again, and then that nigga will go to another direction if there's another team pulling up, and it'll let you know, oh shit, hey, somebody's behind you, you might want to be careful. Now it won't go and touch them and be like screaming and shit, so you'll know, but you get a general idea as a recon character, like, okay, we're surrounded right now. Then moving on to Crypto, he ass. He's still trash. Don't listen to nobody talking about, oh, the nerf to Seer and Bloodhound. No, the nigga is trash. Don't pick him up, okay? Respawn got to do something with him. He ain't it. He still ain't it. All right, so moving on to Seer, man. Let's go ahead and break him down some. So Seer, I thought, had more of like a quality of life change, but it is a nerf to him. So we're going to go ahead and talk about it. And I can make a specific video on all these legends, by the way. Let me just put that out there. I can make a specific video on all these legends and how you should play them individually and everything like that. Anyways, Seer did get a nerf to the tactical ability, where basically he gets to see the heartbeats and everything. So one of the things that they nerfed with it was it kind of has like a slower startup. It's not immediate anymore when you're aiming down sight to look. It's kind of like you aim down sight and then you see it kind of blossom into effect slowly. You know what I'm saying? But it still will stay up forever if you are aiming down sight once it comes up. One thing that is a difference with it, though, is that now it is only going to react to a heartbeat, not necessarily to just a person being there. So think of it like if somebody is out and they got a slower heartbeat or whatever the case may be, and you get a boom, 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 boom. That's how it's going to work for Seer. It's going to pop up. You're going to see the yellow or whatever color you have it on, if you have it on colorblind. And then once the heartbeat stops, it'll disappear, and then it'll pop back up yellow, so on and so forth. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's not just going to sit there the whole time. Now, one of the things that I thought they were going to change that I'm glad they didn't was it still shows multiple enemies in the area and everything like that. Like, if there are four people, you're going to see four arrows in different areas. So it's kind of nice that that isn't a thing that they got rid of for them. So I'm happy with that. Also, with the tactical ability, I think that's about the same. Honestly, I didn't feel too much of a difference. There is a slight delay when the startup for that gets ready to pop off, but for the most part, it's still the same, except for that damn recharge time. Bruh, you got 30 seconds to wait. So let me just tell y'all now, be smart, okay? Don't just be throwing that shit. You gotta really be smart about it. If you knock a nigga or something like that, or if you really break somebody and you gotta win that fight, and you know he hiding or she hiding somewhere trying to get that shield off, then you pop that bitch, you know what I'm saying? And then you get in there and you get active. Don't just be willy-nilly throwing it no more. That ain't the move, y'all. I'm telling you, it's a learning curve to Seer, but he is not ass, just a learning curve. I'm telling you, this nigga is still really good. Then moving on to the ultimate, that's still the same, honestly, y'all. You know what I mean? It's still the same for the most part. I didn't notice anything besides you gotta wait a little longer for the charge up, but you can get an ultimate accelerant or whatever the case may be, and it's really not that big of an issue. So it's still about the same. Then moving on to Vantage, lastly, honestly, y'all, she's still the same too. They didn't change anything on her. They didn't buff or they didn't nerf her. They didn't do anything that would harm Vantage. She's still a really good legend. And honestly, she's probably better now that she can use the survey beacon like how they all can to scan for more enemies. So honestly, she just got, you know, a buff, a slight buff, if you wanted to call it that, after that whole quality of life change. So there you have it on the Recon Legends, man. And in my opinion, I would say from best to worst, it goes Bloodhound, and then Seer is a very, very close second. Like, I think Seer is still a very good and valuable legend in the game. And it just depends on your playstyle and how you want to go about it. Like I said, I can give you guys a full breakdown on how to play Seer after the nerf, because honestly, it is a slight tweak in the way you have to play him, and then I guarantee you, you'll still be moving around and flying around the map like how you were before Seer got nerfed. The third best legend in this category, and not far off either, is Vantage. You can definitely replace Seer with her if you wanted to, but I still think that Bloodhound, Seer are your better two options. And then obviously Crypto is dead last. He's dog water, piss water, whatever you want to call him. He's not good. They need to fix him. But yeah, y'all, that's the video, man. I hope it was informative. Like I said, I can give you guys a full breakdown of every legend individually in this recon section if you want, because I know how to play them for the most part after really just putting in hours of only playing Recon Legends. So yeah, I can do that for you guys if you want. Let me know down in the comment section below, and also subscribe to the channel, and that'll let me know that you guys are interested in that stuff too. But with all that, thank you guys, love you, man. Be careful out there, have a great weekend, and I look forward to catching y'all in the next video.